Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Mutual excellence has defined this rivalry. Oklahoma and Texas, the Sooners and the Longhorns, as the intensity starts to build. Part of the stadium in crimson, the other in burnt orange. The Red River rivalry. Hostilities about to commence. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. And they can forget about returning this one. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's hit immediately. Left, finding his tailback. He gets hit out of bounds. Around the 36-yard line, Sims picks up around 5 yards with that catch, and that'll keep the chain gang moving.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Tackle around the 44-yard line. Taken down right around the 46-yard line. The quarterback kept it for himself and got the first down.
I'll tell you what, you got to be a tough quarterback to run this kind of offense. You take so many more hits and can really get banged around, even on a good day.
Got his tailback open and he can't hang on.
Sims is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second.
From their own 46-yard line. Second down. Grabs it and hammered right there. Hit before it could go anywhere.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Here they come. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
This is the 10th play of this drive. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Oklahoma could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and he splits the uprights. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The football's flying all over the lot in the Big 12. And for SMU, they've now dumped four in a row. In other action, time to check in on Ruston. This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. The Bulldogs grab the win by five.
Reese, 3-0 here. Rice is lined up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Cooks is a guy, Kirk, that is so versatile. I mean, he can be inside, outside. He can jump over the top of you when you get down in the red zone.
And I think that's what one thing this offense has done is they've taken advantage of his versatility because they move him around. It's hard for the defense to really identify where he is. Is he in the slot? Is he over to the right? Is he to the left? Is he to the outside, to the inside? And because they move him around so much, it makes it very tough to really identify him and to be able to match up and get that double coverage on him.
Wouldn't want to be a defensive back against this guy. Fires out to his wideout. The kind of guy that could end up with some national honors because right now he's leading the conference statistically. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Slings it. Here's an opening. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. That's a deep one. That brings us second and nine. And he's tackled right away. Morris makes the tackle at the 30-yard line. First down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled at about the 21. Now player down, and his teammates obviously worried after that play. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Big opening. And they make the stop around the 5-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Here we go. Tackle made at the 3. That brings him second and goal. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Throws it, and it's caught for the touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Pino has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. And
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
The Longhorns wide out, had to leave the field with that injury. We don't want to speculate on how bad it is, but the word we're getting from the locker room is no more football today.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
The running back gets two on the carry.
There's the junior quarterback making a very solid stop. Anytime your corners can contribute like that against the run, it gives your defense another advantage.
Zips it to the back.
They'll bring him down
at about the 39-yard line. Complete. It's the junior.
Brought down to the 37-yard line.
Gets about 4 yards on the option keeper.
That makes it 7-6.
Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. The Longhorns lead it by 4. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter.
Goes
at about the 31. He rifles it. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. The kick is up, and he just drilled it from long range. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. Hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Texas
with a 1-point lead. They go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. They come out in an empty backfield. Run up the middle. Edwards picks up about 7 yards on the run.
Third down.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. Stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
And he's taken down at the 46.
That's a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Check 99.
he's tackled around the 43-yard line. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. McFadden is back awaiting the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He fields the punt at the 20, gets to about the 34-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Texas is up one. The Longhorns taking their first time out of the half. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Fires it out. Tackle at about the 35. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Lawson is back deep to return. And down he goes at the 28-yard line.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this well.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually it could be the team that wins it.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Knocked out of bounds at the 37. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. No gain. That'll bring up third and two.
Come on, come on, come on. Let's go, Mike 50. Mike 50. Easy, easy, easy. Go, 99. Go, 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 go.
Gets out to around the 48. It and he's looking for more. He's taken down at about the 43-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He unloads it. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds.
Man, that was an impressive-looking play. When you can slice apart a defense like that, it puts a seed of doubt in their minds.
From the 13-yard line, first down. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. The Sooners call a timeout. That's their second of the half. the middle for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it 37.
Switch.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
This one should be makeable. Oklahoma can take the lead here with this field goal. Kicks up, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down in the open field.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From their own 39-yard line. First down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. They go back to him on a quick throw. Good open field tackle. Deep ball, laying it out there. Touchdown.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. He splits the uprights with the extra point. This kick return should conclude the first half. Don't be surprised to see some trickery here. Tries to get around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Runs outside for a nice game. So at the end of the half, Texas leads 14-9.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run a reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Very close game now as we start the second half. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again.
Watch nine, watch nine.
Do your job.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. He makes it to the 32-yard line. The quarterback kept it for himself and got the first down.
I'll tell you what, you got to be a tough quarterback to run this kind of offense. You take so many more hits and can really get banged around, even on a good day.
Caught, open field, and he tackles him hard at the 38.
Smith makes the tackle at the 38-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
It out to his receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at around the 44-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
First and 10.
From the 45-yard line, it's first down. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss.
That's a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 11.
Here's the eighth play of the series. The 38-yard line.
Well, we've got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
He's into the open field. Gets out to around the 25. Gets out to around the 15.
That'll make it second and inches.
Watch nine, watch nine. We gotta get the ball, Dean. Get the ball right here. Right, Jack, green 19, regular.
Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down at about the 13. Play to set him up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. Extra point. Texas gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Aaron and out long. And he hauls in the deep pass. Brought down around the 33-yard line. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked the perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Down he goes at the 15. Makes it to the 5. After a decent run up the gut. Touchdown, OU. It as the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
And he converts the extra point. Wright looks ready to kick this one off. A great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. Tackled at the 48. Got an opening. Makes it out to about the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
Great run, and he's brought down in the backfield. It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Throws complete. He's hammered. Right around the 24-yard line. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The Longhorns lead is 5.
immediately tackled.
Thomas on the tackle at the 13-yard line. That will make it second and inches.
Larry, Larry. Let's go, let's go. Here we go.
Gets to about the 11-yard line.
That's a deep three.
You didn't want that? First down. You didn't want that?
Touchdown, Longhorns.
Boy, did he look determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. A 9-play, 79-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around.
Hey, Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball.
Gains his way to the 36-yard line. Get him for a loss.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
Alston is the punter. Oh, excellent punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He gets to about the 31-yard line. From their own 31-yard line. First down. Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Ready, training, yeah.
Gets to about the 34-yard line.
That's good for 83 yards. That'll make it 77.
Gets it out to about the 47-yard line. And the tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
From their own 47-yard line. First down. Back to him, and he gets nothing this time around. Oklahoma's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Sooners, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Up the middle for a nice game.
That makes it a little bit
is waiting for the snap. He's knocked out of bounds around the 24-yard line. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to put the ball away. Just over a minute left. That's a great tackle at the 28. Stops the clock with a spike. From their own 28-yard line, it's third down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Throws it out there. Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds. And 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. He's pushed out of bounds at the 43. He's hit and taken down. Spikes the ball. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And they'll get him in the backfield. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
He wants it all. Wow, you just got to love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season. Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Two down. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. And the ball game's over, and our final score in this one. 28-16, Texas. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup. And boy, was it fun to watch.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.